Good day, kids. Welcome to Agriculture 6. Today we are going to discuss Module 7, Quarter 1, Week 7, Lesson 15, Learning Competencies TLE 6AG0F7, Markets, Fruits and Seedlings. This is Teacher Sandy Cinco. Let's begin. Expectations. Specifically, this module will help you to apply scientific knowledge and skills in identifying fruits and seedlings ready for sale. Keep updated record of trees, seedlings for sale. Plan marketing strategy to be used in selling. Use online marketing of orchard trees, seedlings. Prepare flyers or brochures, and develops plan for expansion of planting trees and seedling production. Marketing is one of the most important factors in determining the success of any fruit and seedlings enterprise. Marketing strategies need to be considered well before production takes place. Here are some factors to consider in marketing and selling fruits and seedlings. The following factors must be considered in marketing and selling fruits and seedlings. 1. Market price. The price of the product depends on the current price in the market, and if the quality is better than the average, they can be sold at a very good price. 2. Location of the market. Selling price of fruits increase in addition cost of transportation. Thus, it is recommended to lessen transportation cost. 3. Consumption period. Fruits in the market are sold at different degrees of ripeness depending on the consumer's intended purpose. Here are some examples of added values you may consider in your products. Healthy and organic. Convenience. Good customer service. Local economy and security. Good quality, packaging, and product delivery. Here's an inspiring story of a successful fruit producer from Cavite. Eddie Ceylon was able to cultivate prolific dragon fruit trees, which produce between 30 to 50 fruits in one post, as time passes by. Ceylon Agri Farm values quality over quantity. This, as Ceylon said, is their secret to their long years growing success. Ceylon Agri Farm employs good agricultural practices, GAP, and one of these is fruit bagging method. By the time the fruit set, they bags them with transparent plastic bags to obtain desirable fruits. Notice the coconut trees in the background, which serve as the main intercrop among dragon fruit trees. Ceylon gets paid for the stem cuttings, which guarantee quality harvest for buyers, but for all the other requirements such as designing, establishing, and maintaining the farm, Ceylon does this for free. Investing, establishing, and maintaining a dragon fruit farm is no joke. So as promised to all our clients, we continue the service of supporting and assisting their farms in order to keep the plants healthy and profitable. We are gratified seeing them harvest tons and tons of fruits, which bring them enough means of livelihood, remarks Ceylon. So, harvesting is picking fruits at their season when they are ready to be sold. Now, we can do the marketing, which means trading goods or products for an offered price. But we should plan ahead of time because fruits are perishable goods or easily deteriorate or decay. Unlike our second product, the fruit tree seedlings, which cost higher when they matured or fully developed. Identifying fruits ready for sale. Table 1. Fruits and the best months for harvesting and marketing. January to February, Kaimito. February to March, Avocado. March to April, Jackfruit. March to July, Duhat. April to June, Pineapple. April to July, Melon, Watermelon. May to June, Mango. May to July, Addis, Macopa. June to October, Calamansi. June to November, Baobas. July to September, Santal. August to November, Guayabano, Lanzones. September to December, Sampaloc. October to November, Dalongita. November to January, Pomelo. December to February, Chico. Year-round, Papaya. Characteristics of marketable seedlings. What are the characteristics of marketable seedlings? 1. The stem is strong, thick, and healthy. 2. It has 5 or more leaves. 3. Establish healthy roots. Now, how are we going to sell seedlings? Let's find out. Methods of selling seedlings. 1. Seedlings in nurseries are usually sold in earthenware or plastic bags. The bigger the seedlings are grown in big metal containers like drums. 2. Seedlings are grouped according to kind and according to size. This arrangement makes it easy to price the product. Hence, prices are largely dependent on the size, health condition, and maturity of the seedlings. Ways to promote and market the product. How are we going to do this? Once your products have undergone quality control inspection and are deemed marketable, you may start promoting them. Below are some ways one can promote and market a product. 1. Conduct survey to find the needs of the community. What fruits are in demand? 2. prepare and distribute pamphlet, flyers, and brochures containing information about the location and the picture of products. 3. Use online marketing tools. 4. Post contact numbers for clients who want to order or inquire about the product. 5. Keeping a record of sales. Social media is one of the influential factor that can help in promoting and marketing product nowadays. What are the marketing strategy used in selling? Let's find out. Marketing fresh fruit starts with educating your clientele about the value of buying healthy food. Constantly communicating and providing helpful information on ways and access to integrate fresh produce into one's diet is a good subtle way to build customer loyalty. It shows that you care about your clients. Today, when more and more people are realizing the importance of a vitamin and fiber-rich diet to one's health, marketing fruits in this manner can be very effective. It might also help to provide detailed information such as the use of organic fertilizer and the variety of produce. The use of online marketing of orchard trees, seedlings is the fastest way to market products nowadays. Another is the preparation, distribution, and posting of flyers, posters in conspicuous places. Marketing strategies in marketing fruit and seedling products. 1. Market selling. The process of buying and selling of farm products from the producers to the consumers is called sales. Producers like farmers or fruit growers commonly go to the marketplace to sell their produce. The different types of selling methods are: A. Selling through a wholesaler or dealer. B. Direct selling, or C. Through cooperatives. 2. Online marketing, also known as internet marketing. It is a marketing strategy that uses the internet, web, and email to introduce products directly to the customers or to deliver promotional marketing messages to customers. In marketing online, you may choose from web marketing, email marketing, and social media marketing. A. Web marketing includes e-commerce, promotional or informative websites, and online advertising on search engines. B. Email marketing involves both advertising and marketing efforts through email messages to current customers and prospective customers as well. C. Social media marketing involves both advertising and marketing efforts via social networking sites such as Facebook, Twitter or YouTube. 3. Flyers or brochures. Flyers and brochures are both forms of advertisement using print on paper intended for distribution to a large audience. Flyers are also called leaflets, are used by individuals or organizations like business industries and are distributed or handed out on the street or in a public place or through the mail. Flyers are cheap to produce and convenient for marketing your fruits and seedlings. Brochure is a form of advertising or marketing booklet that contains information about the products or services. It is a paper document folded into a template or pamphlet and are distributed through display in racks or handed out personally to a target audience. Record of sales. One of the most important parts of any marketing program is to create and maintain a system of tracking production and sales through record keeping. Make sure that the record is updated. Below is a simple table you can use to keep a record of fruits and seedlings sales. Records of the farm activities provide substantial reference in making a marketing plan, creating a budget, and in making decisions. Likewise, records are sources of data in obtaining credit and insurance and in preparing for income tax returns and reports required by the government. Cash record. It is a record of cash value received from cash sales and cash payments for certain period. Cash record reflects the cash accounts in the farm. Cash record shows the date, amount, official receipt number and the remarks wherein it shows total sales in certain period of time. Farm sales record. It is a record of all sales of farm produce. The most commonly used type of farm record that has only one account column representing the total value. The record also shows information about the sale of date, description of item sold, quantity sold, unit in kilograms, and unit value or price. Future plan for expansion. Every business should have a future plan for expansion. A successful orchard is important to the community and environment. Its benefits stand as evidence that expansion is necessary. Tips for future expansion. 1. Community survey and symposium to find the needs of the locality. 2. Build relationship to stakeholders of the community, the local government unit, schools, and private sectors who run related business. 3. Real market status understands the demand. 4. Open for investment and franchising. 5. Availability of experience, skilled orchard technician. Let's remember. 1. Good quality fruits have the same appearance, size, stage of maturity, state of freshness and shape. They can be sold in different ways depending on accessibility, profitability, and convenience. 2. Seedlings are sold in the nursery on a retail or wholesale basis. Their prices are according on the size, heath condition, and maturity of the seedlings. 3. It is necessary to have a record book to write all the business transactions. Update financial record on a daily basis and summarize this on weekly basis. Computing total expenses and subtracting this from total sales gives the profit. 4. Future expansion of planting trees and seedling production depends on the need to increase production and available resources. Okay kids, that is our lesson for today. I hope you learned a lot. Until next time, bye.